Hello and welcome to the learning video on flipped classroom. In this particular learning video, we are going to talk about why should it be used. I am Dr. Payal Dande from SVKM's NMIMS School of Pharmacy and Technology Management, Shirpur campus. Let us understand what we are going to gain after watching this video. We should be able to understand why are we going to use flipped classroom, and secondly, we should also be able to understand the difference between passive and active learning process. So there are two major concepts which we are going to discuss. One, traditional method versus the flipped classroom strategy. And second, active learning versus passive learning process. So let us first talk about the major question, why should we use flipped classroom? To answer this, I would like you to evaluate the two concepts once again. Now, teacher A disseminates the traditional type of teaching method, whereas teacher B is going to talk about the teaching method that is used under flipped classroom. Let us discuss that. What does teacher A do? Teacher A, in the form of traditional method, comes inside the class and disseminates the information in the form of lecture to the students. The students have to learn, understand the concept. Later, the teacher gives the problem in the form of homework to be done by the students. So this is the traditional concept. Now let us talk about the flipped classroom concept, which is being practiced by teacher B. Teacher B gives the lecture in the form of handouts or in the form of learning videos to the students prior to the class. The students are expected to go through the lectures and understand the concept. They have to come prepared to the class. They can also have some doubts and queries that needs to be written, and it has to be brought to the class. Now what does the teacher do inside the class? The teacher first gets all the queries and clarify all the doubts of the students in the class. So it benefits to all. Secondly, whatever was given in the form of homework to be solved later is actually being practiced inside the class under the guidance of the teacher. So the teacher gives problem solving activities, that is the practical application of the knowledge is being done inside the class under the guidance of teacher. Now the teacher may give individual assignment, also can give group activities. So this is called as flipped classroom. Now that you are clear about the traditional and flipped classroom, let us go for a reflection spot. Think as a student and take a pause. First evaluate why the teaching learning method of teacher A is better than teacher B. After doing this, now evaluate why the teaching learning method of teacher B is better than teacher A. Come up with at least 3 points to support each scenario and write your evaluation on a page. Hope you have done this. Now let us summarize. Teacher A teaching method is a traditional method, and the major advantages of such method is that it helps in explaining the theoretical content to the class actively. Similarly, it also helps in clarifying the doubts of the students who ask it inside the class. It helps to evaluate the understanding which is gained by the students. But it has various limitations. First limitation is that teacher is just being an information giver. The students are passive listeners. They are not actively involved in teaching process. Beside this, there are only few responses which comes when the teacher asks questions, and that too comes from the bright students. Similarly, the queries are also asked from the bright students because the other students may be slow learners, or they are not actively participating in the class, or maybe they are unattentive. In such scenario, the teacher is unable to know how many students have understood or are able to apply the concept. Besides, the teacher has given all the problem solving activities, that is the practical application, to be done at home. So he or she would be unable to find if the students have done the homework by themselves or have copied from others. Most importantly, this type of method only assesses the theoretical learning of students. So these are the advantages and the limitations of traditional method. Now let us see the teaching method of teacher B, which is disseminating the flipped classroom type of teaching. Here the major advantage is that the student is involved in every step of learning. So before the class, they have to come prepared, they have to go through the lecture, the handouts or the concept. Then inside the class, they are going to practically apply it. So at every stage they are proactive, and thus such type of teaching leads to active learning. Similarly, it also helps in clarifying the doubts related to application of knowledge as well as the conceptual one. Such type of method assists in practical as well as theoretical learning which is being gained by the students. Moreover, it helps in using the various technology to create the content in a very synchronized way, that is in a pedagogical sequence. So this total step makes it a very effective teaching learning strategy. I don't find much limitations, but I do find a lot of requirements to practice such type of teaching methodology. First of all, it requires a lot of efforts and time from both sides, that is from the side of the teacher as well as from the student part. Similarly, a teacher has to manage the group activities well within the time, require more preparation before the class by the teacher as well as by the student. And such type of teaching method can be acquired through practice. So these are the major advantages and requirements of flipped classroom. I hope now you are very clear why one should go for flipped classroom activity, because it has several advantages over here. Let us also see what the research suggests. The research says that whenever you are giving a lecture or whenever the students read after the lecture, they are only going for passive learning. So hardly 5 to 10% is being gained in terms of learning by the students when they listen to your lecture or when they read the books after listening to your lecture. Besides, there could be 20% of learning that can be gained when audiovisual tools are being used by the teacher to explain the concept. And there is hardly 30% of learning that is made if the teacher is giving some demonstrations to explain the concept. Still, this is called as passive learning. The reason being, the student is not involved in any of this stage. So what is active learning? Active learning is gained when the students start discussing within themselves about the concept. When they have doubts, when they clarify doubts, when they debate with each other. So there where they start making active learning. 75% of learning is made by doing the concept, by doing the active learning, meaning by doing the problem solving. And highest learning is being gained when they start applying the concept and creating something new, or when they start teaching to each other. So here is where we make the active learning. So now you are very clear why should we go for flipped classroom. Time for self-evaluation. After watching this video, ask yourself, am I now able to understand why to use flipped classroom strategy? Am I able to evaluate the difference between passive and active learning process and its importance in the students' learning? Am I able to analyze the importance of active learning process for effective teaching? And will I be able to apply this flipped classroom strategy in teaching the course content effectively? Thank you so much. To learn more about when to use flipped classroom, watch our next learning video 2.3. For any more queries or suggestions, kindly email at pyle.dande@gmail.com. Namaste.